Today marks the 75th anniversary of the liberation of Auschwitz, the largest Nazi concentration and death camp in World War II. In 2005, the United Nations General Assembly designated January 27th as International Holocaust Remembrance Day to honor the victims of the Holocaust. We gather tonight to fulfill a solemn obligation, an obligation of remembrance, to never allow those that died in the Holocaust to be forgotten anywhere in the world. And this evening we have a very, very special program planned with a panel discussion on the moral obligation of the international community and a performance of Whistle, My Mother Was Mengele's Secretary, which is a play featuring Gadar Halron, who traveled all the way from Israel for this performance, which I think you will very, very much enjoy. But first, I'm extremely honored to introduce the mayor of Houston, who made it a priority to participate in this evening's program. So please give a warm welcome to Mayor Sylvester Turner.
Thank you, Dr. Seneca, and certainly to Councilmember Katz. It's good to be with you, to other members of the Council of Corps. It's good to be with all of you. And then to the survivors, especially I want to say good evening to each and every one of you. And you all represent living history for all of us. And then, of course, we assemble today because this is the day of remembrance and we don't want to forget. One thing I do know, that if your memory fades or if we forget, history can certainly repeat itself. So it's important for us always to be vigilant and very mindful of what has taken place. Now, quite frankly, I just felt obligated to come because it's important for all of us, especially in key positions, to stand up and to speak out. And it is with great pleasure and honor to join you all here this evening and this remembrance of the 75th anniversary of the liberation of Auschwitz-Birkenau concentration camps in 1945. And I'm also honored to have with me, with the Council of Corps, that's been very, very active with the city of Houston, and I want to appreciate their support. Thank you to the Holocaust Museum Houston and the different organizations for preparing this remembrance and extending me an invitation to join you this evening. 75 years after the largest systematic extermination of a people in history, it is critically important that we remember what has occurred. And during the Holocaust, 11 million people were killed, more than half of whom were Jewish, and a number that included other religions, the disabled, and ethnic minorities. As memories of the Holocaust fade, and the survivors and eyewitnesses pass away, sadly, we are seeing a global rise in anti-Semitic rhetoric and even violence. Holocaust education provides a vital education for Jews in America and around the world. Understanding this history is important to understanding how society can plunge into madness and how to prevent this from happening again. However, remembering the lessons of the Holocaust requires more than just attending ceremonies. Retelling the Holocaust atrocities, providing public safety resources, and collecting data to combat violent extremism and curbing online hate are necessary to stop violent attacks motivated by hate against all Americans. Increasing awareness and sensitivity of not only anti-Semitism, but discrimination against all groups of marginalized people. We are the most diverse city in the United States. Diversity is an important and strong factor that helps make Houston the great and welcoming city that it is. We are proud of being a city with people of different backgrounds, religions, and cultures. And what makes Houston great is not only our diversity, but also our inclusion. As I've said before, in Houston, we do not build walls, we build relationships. And I can proudly say that in the city of Houston, We continue to fight against anti-Semitism and raise awareness about the horrors and crimes against humanity as seen during the Holocaust. We will continue to speak against intolerance and bigotry, and we will ensure Houston remains the most welcoming city in America. Quite frankly, in our city, if we do not tell the story, if we do not speak to others, especially to a younger generation, then we run the serious mistake of people not knowing what has transpired in the past and run the risk of hate springing up all over the globe. But one thing I can say in our city, that is not acceptable and cannot be allowed. And so we have an obligation from every corner in this city to stand up and say no. But you can only do that if you remember what has taken place in our past. Lest we forget, we have to remember never again. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Mayor. We're so grateful to your leadership and continued support in fighting hatred in all forms. And it wasn't so long ago, on June 22nd, the mayor was here and helped us in opening this facility. And I was telling him earlier, he was just on that day and really was a fantastic speaker and showed everybody the heart and soul of Houston and how special it is here. So I want to give him another round of applause.